Okay, so as you can probably tell by now, trying to add a winch hitch to my trailer. So my theory is the winch that I'm going to put on, I'm going to mount it on a plate and then put a 2-inch square tube that will basically go into a receiver tube on a truck, and then just took one of those receiver tubes and I'm welding it up right there. So what I really wanted to do was put that hitch down on that middle cross beam, that way it wasn't up so high, but that middle beam is not very stout. And I guess I could have braced it, you know, add a little brace in between, but that's a big chunk of channel right there. I figured it's going to be strong enough. I'm not going to be maxing the winch out, at least on this trailer. I figured that was probably my best option. So my welds don't necessarily look the prettiest. I'm going to say that's probably because I'm not a good welder. I'm not scared to admit it. Half of it might be because of I'm using probably one of the best welders you can. Harbor Freight Special Flux Core, about the cheapest you can buy. So it's probably some of it, but we'll see how it goes. Thought it felt like it was getting a little hot that last time when I went. Forgot my gloves.
So I'm done with that one. Still see some smoke coming off of it while it's cooling down. So I actually bought that tube from Rule King, I believe it was. It was actually really long. I think it was 20 inches total. So I chopped it off. I have the other piece over here. I've already got some of it done. I'm just going to drill the hole for this one for your receiver pin. And this one will go on another trailer. Hole leaves a little bit of room for your pin. WD-40 is probably not approved cutting fluid, but it works. And now it's raining. Yay. So now I have a piece of 1 3/4 tube. So that's the piece that I just showed you to go on a trailer. There's some burrs in there, but you get the idea. This is going to be the male end. That's going to go on the winch plate. And cut it up, drill it. Gosh. So the camera battery died. I don't even remember where it left off, but I've started putting this thing together. I've just tacked it up. I was going to just tack it and then slide it into the trailer or onto the truck, make sure everything lines up good before I finish it, but I think I'm just going to go ahead and finish it. I'm in the mood, so... you guys can watch me weld. And yes, this is an OSHA approved setup, just in case you was curious. Welder sitting on a 5-gallon bucket. Rickety setup on 2 rickety sawhorses. And there is a bunch of loose hay right next to the welding area. So you guys are on fire watch. There you go. This side does not look very good, but on this side, for somebody who does not know what they're doing, I think that looks okay. Yeah. Good enough for who it's for. Alright, let's try and finish this video up. It's been a while since I've filmed any of it. The winch is done. What that is. Winch is done and mounted up, and I have used it. So, what I have done for a power source, instead of adding a separate battery to the little tray that the winch is mounted on, I didn't necessarily want to do that because, one, I was going to have the extra added weight of the battery on that tray, and to move that thing around is already, it's pretty heavy. It's probably close to 100 pounds. Instead of having that separate battery with the extra weight, and I was going to have to maintain a battery, either going to have to take it off every time it was used to charge it, or hook in some kind of a trickle charger to most likely the truck. Instead, what I did is I went out and I got a set of jumper cables, 30 foot, 1 gauge, I think they're 1 gauges, chopped one of the ends off and put on the quick connect style on the other end. So one end has still got the alligator clips like normal that go up to the front of the truck and hook into the battery, and then that end hooks right into right there, and that's how the winch gets powered. So there you can see the tube on the back of it that slides right in your receiver hitch of your truck and what I mounted there on the trailer. It all works good. Wish I would have done it a long time ago. So now that I went back and put the whole video together, I realized that I never kind of explained my thought process on the whole thing. So, knew I wanted a winch on that trailer that's in the video. It's a low profile gooseneck. It's really handy for loading cars, lower sitting cars. That way you don't have to go up on a big deck over. And that trailer can still haul, it's rated for 14,000 pounds, so it's still a heavy trailer. So I can pull a truck up on it without any problem, among other things. But, so I knew I wanted a winch on it for easier loading. Could have just mounted the winch on the trailer itself, welded that plate on, bolted that plate on, whatever, and not had to worry about it. But my theory was I wanted to use that winch, want to use that winch in more applications than just the trailer. Put it on that trailer, I can put it on another trailer and load something else up on another big deck over. I can put it on the receiver hitch on the back of your truck if you ever get your truck stuck or you want to pull something with that truck. If you have some, like a Jeep or another vehicle, another truck with a receiver hitch on the front, on like your brush guard, you can put that winch on the front and then pull that out. So how I built it, you can put that winch on basically anything that has that 2-inch receiver hitch, which is a lot of things. So I can take that winch and use it wherever I want. And the reason I think I explained the power source over a battery, having the battery sit on that tray. So using the jumper cables, you can just tie it into whatever vehicle you have the winch on. So that's why I did it. Maybe it's not the right way. Maybe it's not how a lot of other people would do it, but I think it'll work for what I'm wanting to do. Thanks.